What's good, y'all? It's Bo Ross back at it again with another video. So we're gonna check out Botchamania episode 478. You know what we're here for. Should be a very interesting one. Always love checking out some Botchamania. We're gonna get right into this one, man. We're not even gonna waste no time. Let's see what Botchamania has for us this time.
Hi, I'm pro wrestling's premier cinematic genius, Jay George. And for this next scene, you're watching Botchamania, a show that I've never been on because in film, there are no such thing as botches, just happy accidents. And also because I've never botched because I don't suck.
No cheese thing.
1 minute left.
Blatantly gay duo.
Wait, hold on. Who was that?
No cheese thing.
1 minute left.
Blatantly gay.
Is that me? I don't think so. That looked like me a little bit, y'all. But I don't think that's me. What y'all think? I don't know, man. That looked like me a little bit, but I don't think that's me.
Okay.
The guy in the eye. Damn, boy, he's thick.
That may have been me, y'all. What y'all think? Because he got some other YouTubers in that little intro clip. That may have been me. Yeah, he botched it. He botched it. Oh, they botched it. Oh!
Sheamus now going to go high risk, going to go up top.
He was able to redeem himself at SummerSlam.
LA Knight worked out tonight.
Oh, no.
Sheamus sent to the middle of the ring. Belly to belly.
I know that hurt for Sheamus and LA Knight.
You know what they say, if at first you don't succeed.
Fuck it.
Yeah. Oh, no. You all right, bro? Yeah. Book the women's division better. He didn't even come close. How did he miss? I'm so confused. Like, he legitimately just dived in the air. Y'all know the scene from the other guys, Samuel and The Rock? There goes my hero. They just dived. They didn't even make it nowhere near what they were trying to make it to. That's exactly what happened. There goes my hero. What was that? Oh my God. Oh my God. Secondhand embarrassment. That looked bad.
Oh. Embarrassing.
Facts.
What?
What?
Are you going to heaven?
What?
Wow.
Can you hear me now?
What?
Oh, when you get knocked out?
What?
Bro, he's... Y'all going to heaven? What? Oh my God.
And praise the Lord, that's what?
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 And praise the Lord, that's what?
What?
Can I get another one?
What?
What? Wow. Wow.
No. Yeah, Jarrett loves to mock the Bucks. Does the double buy. He twists too much, though. He's going to tear a intercostal.
Lateral press.
I'm still processing.
Oh, I mean, that's why Taz is the best analyst in the game.
He
can even break down the Young Bucks poses.
I was just trying to think about
what. You want to know what an intercostal is? It's not a highway.
Okay.
It's part of your ribcage.
I'll give you a look. It's right there.
Okay, that's good. I was trying to find out where mine was, but
it's not an intercostal.
It was a layer of fat in there, and I couldn't find it. But I know they're about it.
That was nice by Lethal.
That's always funny to me.
I don't know your limits, girl. It's what got Vanderkill, what drove your sister away, and it's why I'm here right now.
You talk too much.
You talk too much.
You never shut up. I said you talk too much. Oh boy, you never shut up.
And it's Charlotte's turn. Chop after chop.
Yeah, I did notice that. The camera had to cut away to it.
Belair. Knees to Oscar, retains.
Mice is picking up all the calls down there.
KOD missed with a boot in Charlotte.
Oh.
Now Charlotte.
I don't know if the human anatomy would allow that to happen. Like SummerSlam.
Hit me.
Tag team action. We want to remind you that for the first time in 11 years, WrestleMania is coming to the northeast of the...
What? I don't know about that, Michael Cole, man. Table didn't break. Looks like this table probably not gonna break either. Nope, that's a strong ass table too. I like how he's just watching him, bro. Hey, didn't break. Like he's just watching him. Oop.
I am the table.
Oh man.
Oh, here goes.
Corbin chance.
NXT Universe in this matchup. You know, Booker, I want to come to you with this question.
People, Stevenson outside so we can use...
You're not Angle. This was rough.
That's called a shucky ducky quack quack moment.
Corbin just broke the count of the official so he can continue to inflict damage on Stevenson.
Corbin understands one. Wait a minute.
Baron Corbin getting a chant in WWE in 2023 lets you know it's not looking too good for my guy right here.
The people of... Wait a minute.
Well, the people out here in the NXT Universe, you know, they voiced their opinion. It's the Great American Bash. They've been fired up since the start of the night.
Baron Corbin.
Whoa! And one more time, Corbin up and over.
They don't care. They do not care. Crowd was all over this match. Nah, that was actually a pretty cool spot. I ain't gonna lie to you. He suplexed him, or kind of like threw him into the barricade. That was a cool spot, somewhat of a cool spot, but it didn't help. We gotta watch that again. Yeah, now he threw him over his shoulder, but still booze.
Say what you want, Buck, about Olympics, not being ready for the Olympics.
this is stupid. This is a mistake. This is a bad decision.
Really? I don't know the reference to that.
But here I am on the climb, and your toilet's in your career's in the damn toilet.
You messed up a little bit.
No.
Ha ha ha, you just gotta.
Also, hopefully, no red is gonna do it again.
You?
That was not me. I can't control what's happening out there. Try again. Oh!
They failed twice. First, he had to just sit with the embarrassment. Then he fell again, then he has to live with it.
That's karma.
For you.
Yeah, karma.
Styles rally.
Yep, this botch right here. He tried to
That's
get him back into it.
The instinct of AJ Styles, just trying to make something out of nothing. Oh. Big opportunity.
Taking a lot of time.
Oh, he was telling him to get up. Oh, no.
Great counter, one, two. Starks plants Punk on the landing.
Man, that looked bad. Oh, both guys fought.
Yeah.
Yikes.
Damn table. It's the audio.
Yikes.
It's the audio that goes with it. It's killing me.
What type of tables are those?
Champa, no time wasted.
Are you looking at the right guy? Do you know which guy's Champa? Champa's the ball guy. There's Big Bronson Reed, 300 pounds, son of a gun, beats everybody up. Champa is now on his feet. Spoke a little too soon. It's okay.
Moves to SmackDown.
Here, guys. And it was almost the Shatter Machine, not quite. Taz, correct me if I'm wrong. That looked like the 3D to me.
Live on Peacock, we're going to be in California for no mercy. As thank you for walking in front of the on camera, they're trying to take our screen time.
That's the story of my life. No respect. Tugger, no respect.
We're getting ready to go to intermission. Before we do that, I just want to shout out a few folks. And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention coming up after. We're gonna do it anyways. Coming up after intermission, the world heavyweight champion, Seth freaking Rollins. You guys.
What's wrong with their mics, man? Yeah, man.
She's been killing it with a faulty mic all night long.
Oh! Oh, Wheeler. I don't even know if I can say the N-word on here.
What?
Well, this you serious?
I
did you say that?
What? The N-U-T-S word. I was going to say, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, no! And don't call me again. Super Dad. I don't care about anything. Thank God we're only reaching 50 people.
Oh, that did not work out. Why is that squad?
What is this? Ooh. What's going on? Commentary's going crazy.
Oh, he's back up. He's got energy.
Bro, what the? What did I just watch?
Can I have your belt?
Did you win this belt? You did not win this belt. Nobody touches this title but me. Go find your mother.
What? Child in between himself and Rob Van Dam.
How low does Jack Perry can go?
Guess what? This kid is secretly part of the con. He's a shill who's been planted there by the booker.
Hi, I'm Mark from WrestleMe.
Hello, I'm Pete from WrestleMe.
And today we're going to be reading an excerpt from Pure Dynamite, the autobiography by the Dynamite Kid. He's not happy.
It's a miserable read, it really is. Some of the matches that I enjoyed most that year were the ones that we had against Harley Race and Hercules Rey Hernandez. Harley Race was now King Harley Race, after winning a tournament for the King's Crown the year before. A couple of weeks after that event, they'd held the crowning ceremony, which was shown on TV. Like I've said before, King Harley liked his drink, whatever the occasion. On the night of the ceremony, they'd put a big throne in the middle of the ring, which Harley had to sit in while he was crowned. He was wearing a big, long purple robe, and Vince had booked the dwarves especially for that night to carry it for him. Boy. After the ceremony, with the music and the speech, which was all very solemn, Harley stood up, and Lord Littlebrook, who was the head dwarf, stood behind him and picked up his robe to carry it. So the king, being a bit drunk, got through the middle and the top rope, but as he stepped through, he missed the apron. As he started to fall, Lord Littlebrook tried to hold him back with his robe, but the force of Harley's fall catapulted the dwarf straight through the ropes, right on top of Harley. I'm sure it was meant to be a very serious occasion, but as you can imagine, all the fans were laughing. Anyway, Harley and Littlebrook picked themselves up, but that was even funnier, because Harley was trying to keep a serious look on his face, but his crown was crushed and hanging off the side of his head. Even when he's telling a humor story, Dynamite Kid sounds miserable.
Yeah, and if I actually remember the book right, I think there's only like three people he likes: the Bushwhackers and Harley Race.
Right.
And even then, it's, you know, he doesn't like anything. He doesn't like anyone. It's frightening and horrible.
Hey, wake up you and listen and watch Wrestle Me wherever you might find it.
And also Botchamania.
Botchamania, I know Botchamania is very successful.
Very well,
yeah.
Doing very well.
Yeah. And streams, lots of streams. Yeah. Just good, isn't it?
Wrestle me, Matthew!
Nah, that was an interesting story, man. Dude, a wee. Of course, Vince would hire a small person to carry the crown and carry his robe. Oh, man.
And now it's got my symbol on it.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I like the reference. X. Yep. It's no longer Twitter, y'all.
Don't touch me, Chop.
He punched my shot.
Look out! We're heading straight for those trees.
Yeah, yeah, relax. Trees down.
Trees down.
Cool. Hey, what do you do if you want the trees up?
Trees up!
What?
Trees down.
Trees down!
Oh, looking good, B-Fall!
What? I'm done, bro. Who took time to edit this like this? Who did this?
Hey, Teddy Long!
From New Orleans, Louisiana, weighing in at 210 pounds, Absolute Ricky Starr!
You want to speak of flawless?
He did. He does have the pose.
That's right. I'm working at my job. I'm completing all the tasks that are assigned by my boss. I'm working. I'm working. I'm working. I'm working. I'm working.
He did do whatever Vince asked for the most part.
We walk away from all this money.
White boy summer.
What? I can make you feel good. So technically that is the line afterwards.
Backing vocals aren't included.
Well, I'm sorry, I did not know the rules.
Okay, well, now you know the rules. Can you answer the question?
Someone should have told me
this. Okay, it's Let Me Lay This Good of Love on You by I Can Make You Feel Good by Kavanaugh.
What was that, bro? Why did he throw that?
Just for further notice, one of your nuts is hanging out of your shorts. You got a big hole.
Oh my god. It's the cinematic hug.
Dumber! Where are you? Why me?
He would feel some type of way about that.
Boneheads, better make sure my gigantic X stays erected atop the roof.
Come on, I get...
And look at Petey just standing underneath the X. He wants it to fall right down.
Yep.
Today we're gonna play a game that's as old as pain itself. Bombardment.
I'm intrigued. What are the rules?
Duck or die! Bombardment! Deal with it! Bombardment! Oh, bitch, son!
What is that, Wade?
Oh, the lemonade.
It's lemonade. You didn't get one?
Yeah, with the whole Becky Lynch kind of sending shots at Triple H on Monday Night Raw.
Oh, thank you, Richie.
Wasn't that funny, boys and girls? Well, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, Napoleon, that sounds like the end.
Wait a minute, I'm the leader. I'll say when it's the end. It's the end.
What? I'll be at AEW All In. Say I. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty cool, man. He's going to be there, man. I heard they're selling out like crazy. I think the number of tickets so far they've gotten up to is like 80,000. So I definitely do plan on checking it out. I don't know if we'll do it on the main channel. I will, you know, most likely probably stream it for you guys on my personal page. I'm gonna have to really prepare myself for that, because that's gonna be a long pay-per-view. But I do think it's gonna be special. 80,000 potential plus people there. Should be a great atmosphere. I'm looking forward to checking it out. I'm gonna give it a fair chance to check it out live for you guys, so be on the lookout for that, man. But I enjoyed this episode, Botchamania. Let me know what was your favorite part of the video. But I appreciate all the love and support you guys are showing on our channel. Road to 150k, and I'm still the undisputed YouTube wrestling champ of the world. Appreciate y'all kicking me. See y'all next one. Peace.